Hello everyone, this is SmartGuy118 Productions here, and today we're going to be taking a look how to read BNSF signals in our territory. Just before I start, just giving a little continent, I have been love filming trains before, essentially in 2018. And before that, I'm becoming a more interested of freight trains coming by and signals that actually good news for rail fanning.
This is going to be part one of how to read BNSF signals, which is through signals. It's just like a traffic light for all cars, except it is for trains that actually provides safety for others.
Now let's talk about the signals. First off, let's talk about automatic signals. The automatic signal represents has the mile marker on it. That represents that is not dispatcher controlled. It's automatic because it's called that, also known as ABS. And CPs, also known as control point, you will find those at switches or other locations that is control point by the dispatcher controlled. Now without further ado, let's actually get into the fun part of how to read BNSF signals. So we have the first restricted signal, which is called a stop signal. Stop signal represents the train has passed, or the control point hasn't realigned the switch, or if there's another train in a block that could be too close to another train. Most restricting signal is a stop signal, and this means the train code must not pass the signal. The aspect is red. If you pass the red signal, that's probably your one way to get fired from the railroad. So the next signal we have right now is the exact opposite as stop. It is a clear signal. The aspect is green over red. In this indicates the train crew will proceed on the main line up to line speed, and this means the track is clear. So that represents all clear to proceed on the main line. You may be wondering what the red over red is. On the other side, it represents stop. Just like before, do not pass the red signal. So the next signal you're seeing right now is flashing yellow. It's called advance approach. This means the train car will proceed and prepare to stop at the second signal ahead. If that next signal doesn't change, then they will slow down to like 40 miles per hour in most cases. The next signal would be approach, and the next after that will be a stop signal, which is most restricting signal in most cases. You may be wondering why there's an extra red below the signal head. The extra red is for the diverging route, which we'll discuss in the next episode. So the red on the bottom has no meaning in the aspect. So they will still continue on the main line if there's no problems. This just means they can have a lot of time to slow down at the next signal, which it will be a solid yellow, which we're coming up next. The last signal we're going to be covering today is called approach signal. The aspect is yellow over red, and this indicates the train crew will proceed and prepare to stop at the next signal ahead. The other signal is red, usually no more than 30 miles per hour in most cases. This gets them enough time to stop at the next signal. Again, most control points will have a red signal, so they can give them enough time to stop, especially if you're at an automatic signal with a milepost location.
Next up, we will talk about the diverging signals, like this red over yellow at Security Whitefield at Fountain Boulevard Crossing. Until this time, this is SmartGuy118 Productions, out.